Ceilings of Sound by Arieric is a truly unique EQ plugin. It uses noise to constantly shape its EQ and also has a nice EQ matching feature. In this review, I will show you how it works and how it can be helpful for you. Arieric contacted me to do a review, and I have to be fair, it was tough to wrap my head around the concept of this plugin. They use terminology like shapes, ceilings and conform. Basically, it uses a lot of linear phase bands and uses noise, white noise, pink noise and brown noise to constantly reference the EQ settings you make. In the philosophy of Arieric, the three types of noise are perfect. I agree that white noise is perfect. So after giving it a lot of thought, I like to compare the workings of Ceilings of Sound to, for instance, the color grading in Adobe Premiere. To have good skin color, regardless if you are as pale as I am or have dark skin, this line will tell you if you have corrected the colors properly for skin tone. The Ceilings of Sound plugin does something like that automatically for every 1.5 dB per octave. According to Arieric, we humans tend to, mostly unaware, to EQ along those noise curve lines. The plugin works like this. You insert Ceilings of Sound on an insert and let the sound play for a while, so the spectrum line, which is the EQ graphic of the audio, settles and is more constant. Then you hit the auto-generate ceiling button to fix the analysis curve of the plugin. This is basically the automated snapshot of the current EQ curve. You can then do a few things, like for instance load up a guide, which is one of the noise curves to align your audio. So I drag the ceiling curve over such a line and I chose minus 15 dB and then I adjust any of these points to the line to line them up. So you can choose different curves. So in theory, having everything lined up sounds closest to noise and perfect. Then do conform spectrum to ceiling. In other words, EQ my audio automatically to match that curve. So frequency-wise, this should be closest to an ideal balance. But of course, as you can hear, this is maybe not at all what I want musically. So I see this method as preparing the audio. All these little tweaks make your audio a bit more balanced and create a good starting point to continue mixing. The audio has been fixed, so to speak. From here, you can EQ what you want by going into the EQ menu like this and adjusting the bands. Since there is, by design, no information on how much you actually boost, and you have all these fixed bands, it's a graphic EQ after all, you have to use your ears, which is always a good thing. There are a bunch of presets included in the plugin, which will all give you all sorts of variations and starting points to EQ from. The one more usable than the other. It all depends on your source material, of course, but they all sound pretty usable. If you have a setting which sounds good to you, you can save it as a preset and load it up whenever you need it. Let's go over a few of those presets on snare drum. First, I will let it loop a few times, of course. And then I'll go to a few presets. Factory presets, snare, and let's just go through the presets. There is no context right now, but you can hear that all those presets sound pretty good. Let's load up this black metal guitar. I will demonstrate the EQ matching possibilities of this plugin. This black metal guitar is ideal because these are reamped guitar tracks of the same DI guitar. The microphone and speakers were different, but the performance and amplitude were the same. So those differences are ruled out and makes for a better comparison. I want this track to sound like this track. I do that by first capturing the EQ curve of the correct track. I let it loop for a while and then capture. Then I save it as a preset. Then I go to the other track and let it loop for a while, so it captures the current EQ curve. Then I load up my preset, and then I hit the Confirm Spectrum to Ceiling button. And then this is the EQ curve of the other track applied to this one, and it sounds like this. You can hear there's a volume difference, let's fix that. It's really close, not a perfect match, but close enough. And after this, you can always adjust a bit more if you want. And of course, this EQ matching is perfect for mastering. You capture the EQ curve of a reference track and apply that curve to your mix and work from there. IAEC informed me that they are working on a mid-side version of this plugin, which will be very interesting for mastering. In the end, it all comes down to, is it usable and does it sound good? The plugin is usable, the terminology is weird. If you work with it for a while, and of course, after watching this review, it all makes sense. And the sound is good. Its linear phase sounds smooth and you can shape the sound in a lot of ways without it sounding wrong. If you want to know more about EQ, check out my EQ tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and I'll see you next time. Bye!